Robert Mueller's Russia probe. Listen.
We're defending, to a large extent, remember, Dana, we're defending here, it is for public opinion, because eventually the decision here is going to be impeach, not impeach. Members of Congress, Democrat and Republican, are going to be informed a lot by their constituents. So our jury is the, as it should be, is the American people.
With me now, CNN senior political analyst Ron Brownstein, our legal and national security analyst Asha Rangappa, and our contributor Selena Zito. Nice to have you all here. Thank you for waking up early on the holiday. And Ron, let me begin with you. What's your read on what Giuliani said? I mean, is he making clear this is just as much a PR battle as it is a legal fight?
Well, as is often the case, he makes explicit what is sometimes implicit. Look, I don't think it is a surprise that Donald Trump is shattering the traditional boundaries and all of the norms on the accepted constraints on the limits of presidential power that we have seen presidents of both parties before him, and that he is acting in ways that are unprecedented on a variety of fronts to try to weaken this investigation. I don't think that's the surprise. No one who watched Lock Her Up in 2016 thought, you know, could have possibly thought that he was going to be personally restrained. I think the surprise is that there is so little pushback from his fellow Republicans in Congress, and that, you know, the idea that there would be some kind of transcendent support for the rule of law that extended beyond kind of partisan affiliation and almost tribal loyalty, I think has really been shredded over the 18 months of his presidency. And you see this kind of radiating circle in which first the White House and the president, then more members of Congress, particularly in the House, and now I think increasingly in polls a larger share of the Republican electorate are all saying, in essence, I think, as you know, challenging the legitimacy of this and basically saying that we are willing to accept these violations of traditional norms as long as we get the policy agenda that we were promised.
To that point, here is what Congressman Adam Schiff, the ranking Democrat on the House Intel Committee, who's been a vociferous opponent, very vocal against this president, here's how he put it on ABC News over the weekend.
The broad question is, how do you counter a president who repeats falsehood after falsehood after falsehood, that has the bully pulpit of the presidency to do it, and has allies in Congress who are willing to support that? And Martha, at the end of the day, there's only one remedy for that, and that is you need to throw the bums out.
Selena, he went on to say that, in his words, Congress is, quote, complicit in all of this. But do you think that Democrats can and should effectively use this to push voters to the polls in the midterms, or is it just more and more of the same and isn't going to energize that group at all?
Well, my concern, if the Democrats, you know, want to take the majority, and history points to that they have that, you know, they have that chance.
Yeah.
I think there's a lesson to be learned from 1998 in those midterms. And in that, if you push too far on issues that are about tribal politics, you tend to lose the voter, whether you're right or wrong. It doesn't matter. I think so what happened to the Republicans in 1998, because they were pushing about the impeachment, about Clinton, about, you know, all the things that went along with Monica Lewinsky, the Republicans went overboard, and they lost seats in that midterm. I think the better thing to do is to just run on the things that are most, you know, as the showcase of your message, right? Mm-hmm. Run on the things that are most important to people in their lives, in their communities, and in their families. And that tends to be on pocketbook issues, on the economy, on Medicare, on Social Security.
On the economy, which the president has, you know, is going to be very helpful to this president if things continue as they have been. Asha, let me ask you a legal question about something that struck me. I was running yesterday listening to Dana's live interview of Rudy Giuliani as it was happening, and I sort of stopped in my tracks when he said, he narrowed the scope. He said, look, this is what Mueller's team has agreed to an interview on with the president. Two things, collusion and obstruction. Okay, we knew those were the two big things. But then he said this about obstruction. Listen.
The obstruction part, I'm not as comfortable with. I'm not. The president's fine with it. He's innocent. I'm not comfortable because it's a matter of interpretation, not just hard and fast, true, not true.
Is he helping Asha, the president legally with statements like that?
It's not clear to me exactly what he's trying to do with statements like that. You know, it does make sense to me that he is trying to do some swaying in the court of public opinion. But what he also needs to do is actually realize that he's going to have to make some arguments in a court of law, and they're going to have to be coherent, and they're going to have to be well-researched. A lot of the issues that he is staking his claim on are constitutional issues. Things like he's counting on, for example, that a sitting president can't be indicted. That is not a settled issue. Even former independent prosecutor Kenneth Starr wrote a memo back in 1998 stating that he believed that a sitting president could get a president obstruct justice. Most scholars say yes. So at some point, if he wants to actually make the kinds of claims that are going to protect his client, he's going to have to put together a real legal argument, and I have not seen one yet.
Ron, what did you make of what we heard from Marco Rubio, fellow Republican, sitting Republican senator, talking about the legitimacy of the FBI using this confidential source in the early days of the Russia probe? Here's how Rubio put it on CBS.
If there are people operating in this country trying to influence American politics on behalf of a foreign power, it is the FBI's job to investigate those people. What I have seen so far is an FBI effort to learn more about individuals with a history of bragging about links to Russia that pre-exist the campaign. If those people were operating near my office or my campaign, I'd want them investigated and I'd want to know about them. That's what I've seen so far. If it turns out to be something different, we want to know about it.
Do you think, Ron, that hearing statements like that from Marco Rubio, essentially saying, I think what I've heard so far is that all of this was done legitimately, does that matter? Does that move the needle in terms of the president spouting off these Spygate unfounded theories?
Well, I don't think it does because it isn't strong or concerted enough or consistent enough across the party. It's unfortunately you call it Jeff Flakeism, you know, kind of intermittent demurral from the kind of the general thrust of the argument. But I think the bigger message that Republican voters are taking is that most of the party leadership, particularly in the House, where Paul Ryan has repeatedly defended the efforts of members of the Republican caucus to, in a variety of ways, try to undermine this investigation and to, in effect, open a second front behind the lines against Robert Mueller. I think that is the dominant message. You know, as I said, there's kind of been a kind of radiating circles here. You've had started with the White House and the president trying to undermine this. They've enlisted most members, I think, of the Republican caucus, particularly in the House, in kind of amplifying that message. Obviously, it's being amplified constantly on conservative media, talk radio, Fox, et cetera. And then you see it moving among Republican voters. And so, you know, the great risk that we're kind of barreling toward is that if, in fact, Bob Mueller does decide that it's not worth challenging these 1970s and 1990s determinations by the Justice Department that you cannot indict a sitting president, and then ultimately Rudy Giuliani is right, and this goes to the political arena, that he finds something significant and the Congress refuses to act, the social divisions I think that we see now would be tremendously magnified.
Wow. Ron, appreciate it. Important point. Asha, thank you. Selena, nice to have you all. All right, next we're going to take you back to Arlington now.